In Mode 2, Civilization offers you four sequential switches, one for each output. Here are some of the key features for Mode 2. You can set up a sequence for each output with up to 8 steps of audio or CV. For each step in the sequence, you can select one of the four input signals, a steady CV, a skipped step, or a random CV value. Each step can have its own gain value, allowing you to attenuate your signal levels to taste. Each of the four sequences can have its own length, playing order, and clock divider. Quantization, sample and hold, as well as glide, are also available individually for each of the four sequences. Sequences can be frozen and resumed with or without reset at any time. Clocking is provided via the CVA and CVB input or via busgate. Let's get into the details and start with setting up a sequence with audio signals. We'll begin by feeding a steady clock signal into the CVA input. The four right-hand encoders are now flashing in sync with the clock, with step one being indicated by a short white pulse. We've patched the sine, pulse, and sub-oscillator outputs of a VCO module into inputs 1, 2, and 3. Input 4 is receiving a pink noise signal. And now we'll set up a sequence, switching through these four input signals in an 8-step pattern. Press the right-hand encoders to select one out of the four sequences. By default, each sequence has all of its steps set to the respective inputs, as indicated by the color of the LEDs. Press right-hand encoder 1 to open the step type program page for sequence 1, which is hardwired to output 1. Each encoder represents one of the 8 steps in the sequence. Orange is for input 1, which is the sine oscillator in this case. Green is for input 2, fed by a pulse wave. Blue is for input 3, it's a sub-oscillator. Magenta is for input 4, and that's our pink noise. We can now select a different signal for each of the 8 steps in the sequence. Simply turn the encoders and set them to the desired value. As you can hear, we now have a rhythmical 8-step pattern with different audio signals appearing at each step of the sequence. Selecting red will skip the step, effectively shortening the sequence. The length of the sequence can be set to anything from 1 up to 8. All of these changes can be made on the fly without stopping the sequencer. Steady CV and random CV are also available per step. We'll look at these in another video when we're dealing with control voltages. Back on the performance page, you can use any of the four left-hand encoders to freeze the corresponding sequence. Turn the encoder one tick to the left to stop, and the sequence will be halted on the current step. Turn one tick to the right to resume playback at the start of the sequence. The phase of any clock division that might be active will also be reset. Alternatively, you can turn the left-hand encoder one tick to the right to pause the sequence. When resuming playback, the sequence will continue from the current step. Any clock division will simply resume without reset. On the performance page, the LEDs of the right-hand encoders show you the color of the current step. Turn any right-hand encoder to change the current step on the fly. Let's set the gain for each step. Pressing any of the four left-hand encoders takes you to the step gain program pages. Pressing the first left-hand encoder takes us to sequence 1, which is the one we'll be using. By default, all steps are set to the maximum level, which is unity gain, with all encoders at full brightness. As you turn the encoder to the left, each tick will reduce the gain. The LEDs get darker as you turn down the level. When the value reaches 0, the LED is off. So far, we've only used one out of civilization's four outputs. Now, let's take a look at what's possible if we route an audio signal through all four sequential switches and their respective outputs. We'll take a simple noise burst and feed it into input 1. All steps must be set to orange, which is input 1 for all four sequences, as we'll only be using the input 1 signal for this example. Output 1 is panned all the way to the left in our stereo mix, while output 2 is panned all the way to the right. Makes sense, right? Using the step gain function, we can now let our noise burst appear at either output 1 or 2 or both, making for some really cool panorama effects. Let's route output 3 through a digital delay effect, adding another layer of complexity. The delay effect is now added to the center of the stereo mix. Again, we're using different gain settings on sequence 3 to spice up our pattern. We've still got output 4, so let's throw a reverb on one of the steps. Now, let's add the resulting stereo reverb to our mix. And all of this with just one simple noise burst. Imagine the possibilities once you start using all four inputs, with different sequence lengths, resets, or playback directions. These are just two examples of what you can do with audio signals in Mode 2. Watch part 2 of this video, which deals with control voltages and the config pages for Mode 2.